We're discussing enterprise browsers, an emerging category for securing unmanaged device access, with Anand Oswal from Palo Alto Networks. Tell us about Palo Alto Networks and about your role.
Palo Alto Networks is a leading cybersecurity company in the world. We want to make every day more secure than the day before. I run the network security business at Palo Alto Networks, ensuring that all users, all applications and data are consistently secure across all our control points.
We're discussing enterprise browsers and unmanaged devices. When we talk about unmanaged devices, what do we mean?
Unmanaged devices are devices like my personal laptop or my phone that are accessing critical corporate applications and corporate data. And Michael, over 50% of devices that access corporate applications and data are unmanaged devices.
How big a problem is this?
About 90% of successful malware originates from unmanaged devices. Now, 80% of data breaches that happen from applications and email, which are typically accessed via browser. I spoke to a customer. They had these site reliability engineers, DevOps engineers, who was using a personal laptop. An attacker hacker got into the personal laptop and exploiting a vulnerability in their media software package, was able to install malware, keylogging software in this case, and was able to steal credentials. This all happened from unmanaged devices. So unmanaged devices is a huge, huge problem. That's why I think we need to be able to secure these devices so they can access the applications and data consistently and securely.
Anand, Gartner has identified this as a very important emerging category. Why has this become such a big issue?
Gartner has said that by 2030, enterprise browsers will become the platform by which unmanaged devices will access applications and by which this access will be secured. And by 2026, they say that over 25% of organizations will be starting to adopt enterprise browsers.
What is driving the growth of enterprise browsers? What's happening in the environment?
In the past, users had to choose between security and agility and productivity and a better user experience. So to get secure access, would to be to deploy a VDI on desktop as a service, which are costly, but also have a poor user experience. Or you want to ensure that for every single contractor, you ship a particular laptop and have a managed device. These are cost prohibitive. So enterprise browsers changes the game, where now you can secure your unmanaged devices consistently and also add a new layer of protection for your managed devices to protect from key things like advanced phishing attacks, key logging, and so on and so forth.
So how significant are the risks associated with these unmanaged devices?
Think about it in three key important steps. First, as we talked earlier about SASE, SASE is Secure Access Service Edge, bringing networking and security together, delivered as a massively distributed cloud service, and ensuring that you can secure the users as they access the applications and data, no matter where the user is, no matter where the applications are. So that was what we call as Zero Trust Network Access 2.0, where we want to have continuous trust verification, continuous security inspection, and provide that consistently across all users and applications. From the enterprise browser perspective, you can have additional checks to ensure that the posture of your device is right. And we can do this maybe every 90 seconds. The second key part of the solution is ensuring that you're securing the browser workspace. As you know, majority of work happens today in the browser. So how do we ensure your passwords, your bookmarks, your cookies, your keychains, and so on and so forth are moved from just consumer encryption to trusted encryption? That's the first thing. The second, how do you ensure that you're adding an additional layer of runtime protection in the browser from things like key logging, screenscaping, device certificate manipulation? Third, how do you ensure that you're protecting the browser extensions so that when you're accessing untrusted websites, you have full control of all components of the browser? You have full visibility into all the extensions that have been installed in the browser and control over those. And third step is around all the controls for data loss prevention on the browser. So how do we ensure that when you're seeing sensitive information and you're not authorized for it, I mask sensitive content. How do you ensure that you are either allowed or not allowed to share on collaboration applications? To ensure that you can only upload sensitive data and files to corporate accounts, a corporate G drive, Microsoft account, or a Box account. How do you ensure that if I download a file, it's encrypted, but can be only opened within the browser? So all of these constructs for data loss prevention are part of the solution for having the acquisition of talent, which provides unmanaged device access security, but also additional layer of security for managed devices.
Unmanaged devices, our phones, our laptops are everywhere. What are the challenges that organizations face trying to secure these devices?
I think first, they don't have consistent security over unmanaged devices today. So I have consistent security across all my users in the office, whether they work from the office or work from the home, from managed devices. So we don't have that for unmanaged devices. Second is that we don't have visibility and control over all the activity happening from the unmanaged devices. I can only secure something if I see what's happening. So we want to make sure that we are able to secure all activity, activity happening on managed devices and activity happening on unmanaged devices. We have all the visibility, control, the logging information, so we can correlate these as needed.
Anand, you've described the background. What can organizations do to address this very growing problem?
We want to ensure that we secure both your managed device and unmanaged device. But we also want to ensure that we do this consistently. So when we think about Prisma SASE, which is protecting these users, these devices, we want to protect the user on any device, a managed device and unmanaged device. We want to provide the consistent set of security capabilities for any access to applications or data that sit anywhere. So we're really solving the any-any problem. Any user on any device, managed or unmanaged, accessing any applications and any data over any network. We are securing that consistently with the best-in-class security services. We're able to provide a consistent view to the administrator. So they have visibility into managed and unmanaged devices. This all has to happen without compromising the end-user experience. Because as end users, we want the most optimal experience on any device that we are.
So your goal then is to provide a very consistent experience and set of policies regardless of the device, whether it's a device that's issued by the organization or a personal device owned by an employee, a contractor, what have you.
Because you get a lot of productivity when you're on the road. You're accessing very sensitive information from your personal laptop or your personal phone. It gets you speed, agility, and productivity. But you don't want to compromise with security. You want to have all the benefits of those, but you also want to ensure that you weave in all the layers of security so you can get both of them done.
Is there a layer of complexity that gets added in as well, or is it seamless?
It's seamless. And it's also the best user experience because as you add more users or unmanaged devices, the single way to download the enterprise browser. It's built on the same constructs of consumer browsers like Chromium, but then you add a layer of security. You want to ensure that all your browser surface area controls are done so that there's no phishing, no malware that can do key logging, screenscaping, and then providing those additional controls of data, especially for your sensitive data, where either you mask them, you can't print it, you can't copy it, you can download it, but it's only open in the browser, you can't upload it to your personal Gmail account, and all those controls. So it's adding that additional layer of security, even for managed devices, for your sensitive applications.
So regardless of the device, you have a consistent set of policies and a consistent approach to security across the enterprise.
The whole approach to security is on the principles of zero trust. Zero trust talks about least privilege access. It talks about checking the posture of this device on a continuous basis, continuous trust verification, continuous security verification. And now we're extending those constructs to unmanaged devices. We're adding additional layer of protection, even on managed devices, for browser applications to provide additional protection for runtime browser attacks and also controls for data security.
Anand, you acquired a company called Talon specifically to address these issues. Can you tell us about that?
We acquired Talon in December. Talon is headquartered in Israel. They're the leading enterprise browser company. Bringing all the benefits I talked about of securing unmanaged devices, of providing this additional runtime protection on browser applications, providing the additional controls of data visibility and control for the applications, and bringing it together with SASE, which is the leading solution in the market that Palo Alto has, which provides zero trust network access, firewall service, data security, secure web gateway, brought together through a common layer of autonomous digital experience management. And we can extend all those constructs to manage and unmanaged devices now. So now the network security admin has a comprehensive view of all users on any device, both company issued managed devices, but also the unmanaged devices, accessing any applications and any data sitting in any location.
Can you give us a little more detail about the Talon product specifically and why it's so important at this time?
Talon brings in enterprise browser technology. It's based on Chromium, but it's adapted for the enterprise. So adding the additional layers of security. What Talon really did well was ensuring that all the things that are happening in the browser are secure. If you think of data controls, from things like masking of data that are very sensitive information when you're viewing them, to data exfiltration, they're not allowed to upload it to different public websites or personal accounts, to all the things around data control. Can you print a given document? Can you share a given document? Even on a collaboration application. If something is displayed, you want to watermark the application. If you download an application, I want to only ensure that I'm opening it within my secure browser. So providing additional layers of control that. Think about your browser components, your cookies, your passwords, your access cards, your tokens, your autofills, moving away from consumer encryption to trusted encryption. And then when you access untrusted websites, how do you ensure that you have full control on disabling different components, having full visibility into what extensions are in the browser and full control over them? Those are critical aspects that Talon brought together in the acquisition. We've taken all these best-in-class components that we had with Talon, all the amazing capability that we had in the leading solution for SASE with Prisma SASE, and brought these together to ensure that now we're able to secure all devices across all the user base, applications and data, consistently manage them, and have all the layers of visibility and control.
From a management perspective, integrating Talon with Palo Alto, I'm sure, provides a variety of benefits, both from a security standpoint and from a user experience perspective.
It provides a lot of benefits from security, of course, because you're extending all the best-in-class security capabilities and additional layers of protection for both managed and unmanaged devices. It provides incredible operational simplicity for the enterprise because now they have full visibility of all users on managed devices and unmanaged devices, and they're able to correlate them. If they're accessing sensitive applications and data, you have full visibility and control on that.
So the simplicity and ease of use is a crucial component.
Simplicity, ease of use, but most important, consistent, best-in-class security.
Anand, what's the best way for organizations to embark on this journey with enterprise browsers and securing unmanaged devices?
So if we think about enterprise browser, we have two big capabilities. The first is, how do you secure these unmanaged devices, just like you secure your managed devices? And how do you allow them to have an additional layer of protection on the browser, advanced phishing attacks, advanced malware, etc.? And how do you do that consistently across the entire organization without having yet another point product, yet another security tool? What the journey for most of our customers is that many of them have already secured their users from managed devices, accessing applications and data. It's very easy to extend the unmanaged devices on the same consistent Prisma SASE architecture with the best-in-class security, and then have that common layer of manageability in terms of how do you configure, how do you monitor, and how do you get insights. Now, there are certain set of customers who have now just starting this journey. They have not yet gone into Prisma SASE yet, but they want to secure these unmanaged devices. 40% of the workforce today identifies themselves as contractors or independent workers. Many of these contractors and independent workers access corporate resources to their own personal device. So how do we extend solutions of Prisma SASE for the contractor workforce or workforce that is having unmanaged devices? So the goal is to ensure that all users, whether they are contractors, independent workers, employees having managed unmanned devices, are accessing any application, any data, through a common layer of best-in-class security and having additional layers of protection against these browser runtime attacks, but also having all the controls the organization needs on what's happening in the browser, what kind of controls you can have.
With the huge proliferation of personal devices, it sounds like the enterprise browsers fill a crucial gap in the security arsenal, we could say.
Not only is it helping us secure the unmanaged devices, which are accessing critical applications and data, which are not secure today. And then for your managed devices, adding an additional layer of security to protect you from attacks that are happening on browser runtime and having good control about the entire browser attack surface.
Education plays a very important role in many aspects of security. How does education figure into this?
If all organizations understand that 90% of successful malware originates from unmanaged devices that their employees have. So part of it is understanding all what's going on. 40% of the workforce today is independent workforce or contractor workforce. And many, many of these workforce are accessing critical applications and data from unmanaged devices. So of course, education plays a very key role to ensure that organizations understand the risks associated with unmanaged devices and what's going on. And also to know that majority of the data breaches are happening through applications and email that are accessed via the browser. So as the browser becomes the workspace of the future, how do you ensure that you're securing that consistently across your managed devices, your unmanaged devices, and how do you add additional layers of protection as needed?
So education is crucial because these unmanaged devices are a very significant source of potential attacks.
Yes, absolutely.
Anand, any concluding advice on securing unmanaged devices for technology and security professionals?
Securing all devices is very, very important, right? Securing your managed devices and securing your unmanaged devices. In the past, if you want to really secure your unmanaged devices, it was costly and the user experience was not good because you used desktop as a service or VDI applications, which impacted your user experience. With Secure Enterprise Browser, you have really easy and more secure way of securing your unmanaged devices. You can add additional layer of protection even for managed devices. And all of these can be delivered consistently across the workforce. So the consistent layer of security capabilities from advanced threat prevention to advanced malware to URL filtering are applied consistently across your managed unmanaged devices for any applications and data they access. And then you have full management capabilities which are consistent. So where the administrator is allowed to set policies, look at visibility, and look at logging information, monitoring capabilities is consistent now across both these managed and unmanaged devices with best-in-class security capabilities.
So thinking holistically across the full range of devices, unmanaged devices and managed devices.
Yes, unmanaged devices, managed devices, having the best-in-class security capabilities and then ensuring that you're able to now have full visibility into the activities, the insights, so that you can drive the actions consistently.
Anand Oswal, thank you so much for taking time to speak with us.
Michael, always a pleasure to talk to you. Thank you.